I'm looking for my connection. We were rerouted through wherever it is we are.
I work with Harkins Theaters, the largest independently owned theater chain in the U.S., which is where people will be seeing this film. So congratulations.
Oh. Really? Independently owned theater chain?
Yep. Fantastic. Over 80 years of ultimate movie going.
Okay.
And personally, my favorite theaters in the U.S. Yeah, I'm a little bit biased.
Hello, Wilhelmina.
Hello, William.
I travel a lot, so obviously I'm fixated on some of the travel aspects of this. My first question, who was the calm, soothing voice that I heard on the PA throughout your film that essentially becomes another character?
Thank you for asking that. That is a man known to you as Hal Liggett.
The National Weather Service has identified the storm as a bomb cyclone.
Bomb cyclone?
Yes.
What I love about his voice in the movie is that he's just got all this compassion, all this warmth, all this authority, but he's also really irritated by them. And he's got all this soul. You know, like a couple of times a couple of those lines, he just breaks my heart.
See, I grew up riding the subways in New York, so I'm used to hearing voices on the internet talking to me, but it sounds like this. Like, if you want, like, here's some advice for you, David, for the rest of your life.
What?
Watch the closing doors.
When people break up, there's the thing that they tell each other, there's the thing they tell their friends, and then there's the truth.
I want to ask kind of a personal question. There is a line in there, Megan. I know you helped write the film. There's a line in there about dating a musician. And obviously fans of yours who have followed you might catch on to that. And I'm curious, when you're writing something, a romantic comedy, how tough is it to want to maybe inject something from a personal experience, maybe not, or maybe kind of nod to it?
I think writing everything is for you, your life, everyone else's life, and it probably doesn't have the exact correlation that you may think
it has.
Did you
date Sheryl Crow? Is that
who wouldn't love to date Sheryl Crow?
I'm the last to know.
She has a song in the movie, so
yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
But it's not a direct correlation to my life at all. I mean, I think a lot of times musicians write songs and people are trying to read into the inferences into their life. And
it's the same with actors who write.
Yeah.
Another travel question. Your character carries that rain stick. And my first thought, how the heck did she get this on the, where did she put this?
That's part of the magical realism.
Part of the magical reality.
Of course it is. But it made me wonder, what is the craziest thing you all have tried to get on it without having to check it in?
Oh, I got a good answer for that. Before 9/11, of course, things were easier to move through airports.
Yep.
And I came down to LA from Vancouver. I won a Golden Globe, right?
Oh.
So I had a Golden Globe, a heavy statue in my bag. And I was going through TSA, and bag goes through, and the guy goes, "Sir, do you have an award in your bag?" And I was like, "I sure do. That's a Golden Globe."
That's great.
Do you have an award in your bag?
Coming down from Banff in Canada. And I was traveling with Carrie Fisher, and she was like, "Meg Ryan, you have to know how to tap dance." So she taught me how to tap dance in the security line there before she was disciplined.
Obviously, at the end of this, we see those beautiful words for Nora. And I'm curious, is there a moment in the film that you think she'd really get a kick out of or be particularly excited by?
I think she would like the scene where we're trying to they disagree on good and bad developments in the since they've seen each other, and they land on the internet and they have this really petty exchange about it.
Right.
I think she'd like that.
I think she
would
too.
She said that she thought of rom-coms and love stories as kind of a delivery system for an editorializing on
the world. She really liked doing that, secretly doing it. So it didn't seem like medicine, but she was able to talk about big business or business. Literally, we could do BAM.
It's like the new.
It's like we're almost already doing that junket.
It's like the BAM, but it's
BAM.
With an F.
Please don't ruin this. Pure and simple, just for you.